الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to Quran Circle 8, where we listen to verses of the Quran, one page for every reciter, and we talk briefly about the verses and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the people of the Quran. We are in Surah Al-A'raf. So grab a mushaf inshallah ta'ala, open it, page 154. And verses 131 to 37, this is the first reciter would recite this for us inshallah ta'ala, to learn the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to benefit, to be in the gatherings of where the Quran is being recited, to learn how to recite. And these are all acts of servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But before we start, I would like to introduce the reciters with us today. We have Sheikh Ayman Abdul Mun'im, barakallahu fik, and Sheikh Ahmad Rajab, and Sheikh Asad Al-Hawi, and Sheikh Abdul Rahman Sa'id. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all for coming. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a blessed episode and all the series to be blessed by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, page 154 and Surah Al-A'raf. And Sheikh Ayman, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد وكلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا إنه لا يحب المسرفين. قل من حرم زينة الله التي أخرج لعباده والطيبات من الرزق قل هي للذين آمنوا في الحياة الدنيا خالصة يوم القيامة كذلك نفصل الآيات لقوم يعلمون. قل إنما حرم ربي الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن والإثم والبغي بغير الحق قل إنما حرم ربي الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن والإثم والبغي بغير الحق وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا والإثم والبغي بغير الحق وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا وأن تقولوا على الله ما لا تعلمون. ولكل أمة أجل فإذا جاء أجلهم لا يستأخرون ساعة ولا يستقدمون. يا بني آدم إما يأتينكم رسل منكم يقصون عليكم آياتي فمن اتقى وأصلح فلا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. والذين كذبوا بآياتنا واستكبروا عنها أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. فمن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا أو كذب بآياته أولئك ينالهم نصيبهم من الكتاب حتى إذا جاءتهم رسلنا يتوفونهم قالوا أينما كنتم تدعون من دون الله؟ قالوا ضلوا عنا وشهدوا على أنفسهم أنهم كانوا كافرين.
جزاكم الله خيرا. يا الله سبحانه وتعالى reward you. After the story of Adam عليه السلام, Allah سبحانه وتعالى calls the sons of Adam till the day of judgment to go to the houses of Allah, the masajid, the places of worship, the best spots on the face of earth, and to enjoy what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permitted to eat and drink, and not to transgress. Because indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love those who are excessive, excessiveness in all things. And that's why the one that has the right to make permissibility or forbidden matters is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's for the believers in this life, and it's going to be pure for them in the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade al-fawahish, all sins that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade, specifically what relates to what is abhorred by the pure nature of the human beings, relationships between men and women in a forbidden way, whether it's openly or inwardly, whether it's transgression or evil doing, any type of a sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid by the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the worst of all is to associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that every nation has a set limit, every person has a set limit in this life, and everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The covenant from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the human beings that every time a messenger is sent, that they would follow the messenger of Allah, and they would be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by following the messengers of Allah. And as for those who transgress and arrogantly turn away from the message of the messengers, they are the people of the hellfire. And therefore there is no one more of an evildoer than someone to invent a lie and attribute it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by claiming any matters of religion or associating partners with Allah. These people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them severely. And the things that they used to invoke besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it does not exist, it's falsehood, and it won't be there for them when they need it the most, when they return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next page in the set of verses, in page 155 and verses 38 to 43, and Sheikh Ahmed, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قال ادخلوا في أمم قد خلت من قبلكم من الجن والإنس في النار. كلما دخلت أمة لعنت أختها حتى إذا اداركوا فيها جميعا قالت أخراهم لأولاهم ربنا هؤلاء أضلونا قالت أخراهم لأولاهم ربنا هؤلاء أضلونا فآتهم عذابا ضعفا من النار. قال لكل ضعف ولكن لا تعلمون. وقالت أولاهم لأخراهم فما كان لكم علينا من فضل فذوقوا العذاب بما كنتم تكسبون. وقالت أولاهم لأخراهم فما كان لكم علينا من فضل فذوقوا العذاب بما كنتم تكسبون. إن الذين كذبوا بآياتنا واستكبروا عنها لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء ولا يدخلون الجنة حتى يلج الجمل في سم الخياط وكذلك نجزي المجرمين لهم من جهنم مهاد ومن فوقهم غواش وكذلك نجزي الظالمين والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها أولئك أصحاب الجنة لا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها أولئك أصحاب الجنة هم فيها خالدون ونزعنا ما في صدورهم من غل تجري من تحتهم الأنهار وقالوا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق ونودوا أن تلكم الجنة أورثتموها بما كنتم تعملون
بارك الله فيك الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned the nations those who will enter the hellfire from the jinn and mankind and every nation entered the hellfire they curse one another and the first of them would say to Allah oh Allah or the last of them would say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let curse or punish the first more because they are the ones that led us astray. And the first would say that you deviated yourself. We have nothing to do with your deviation. Mm-hmm. The disputes of the people of the hellfire is mentioned in these verses and every person, every nation responsible for their actions. And therefore those who disbelieve and deny the ayat and the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and arrogantly turn away from the truth, the gates of the heavens and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would never be for them, impossible to happen for them, as impossible as the camel to enter into the eye of a needle. It would never happen, and therefore it would never happen to them to receive the mercy of Allah if they die in that state. And they are the people of the hellfire. On the other side, those who believed and did righteous good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. They are the people of Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not put upon them where they cannot bear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment when the believers they enter Jannah, it will be taken away from their hearts any hatred and anything whatsoever when it comes towards one another or anything of good or bad thing because this Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for those who are pure and no one will enter Jannah unless they are purified. And they would praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they enter and they would say that it's all by the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messengers of Allah came with the truth and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call them to enjoy what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for them in Jannah as a result of what they used to do on the face of earth. And then this dialogue between the people of Jannah and hellfire will take place in the Day of Judgment. And this is the next page, 156 and verses 44 to 51. And Sheikh Asad, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ونادى أصحاب الجنة أصحاب النار أن قد وجدنا ما وعدنا ربنا حقا فهل وجدتم ما وعد ربكم حقا قالوا نعم فأذن مؤذن بينهم اللعنة الله على الظالمين الذين يصدون عن سبيل الله ويبغونها عوجا وهم بالآخرة كافرون وبينهما حجاب وعلى الأعراف رجال يعرفون كلا بسيماهم ونادوا أصحاب الجنة أن سلام عليكم لم يدخلوها وهم يطمعون وإذا صرفت أبصارهم تلقاء أصحاب النار قالوا ربنا لا تجعلنا مع القوم الظالمين ونادى أصحاب الأعراف رجالا يعرفونهم بسيماهم قالوا ما أغنى عنكم جمعكم وما كنتم تستكبرون أهؤلاء الذين أقسمتم لا ينالهم الله برحمة ادخلوا الجنة لا خوف عليكم ولا أنتم تحزنون ونادى أصحاب النار أصحاب الجنة أن أفيضوا علينا ونادى أصحاب النار أصحاب الجنة أن أفيضوا علينا من الماء أو مما رزقكم الله قالوا إن الله حرمهما على الكافرين الذين اتخذوا دينهم لهوا ولعبا وغرتهم الحياة الدنيا فاليوم ننساهم كما نسوا لقاء يومهم هذا فاليوم ننساهم كما نسوا لقاء يومهم هذا وما كانوا بآياتنا يجحدون.
جزاكم الله خير. بارك الله فيك. The people of Jannah will call the people of the Hellfires and would say to them that we found what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us to be the truth. So did you find what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised you to be the truth? The people of the Hellfire would say yes. And then a caller between them would say that the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is upon the wrongdoers. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the punishment of the Hellfire, of the people of the Hellfire more, and the pleasure of the people of Jannah more when they see one another. The people of delight, when they see the people in the punishment, they will be so much grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the people in the punishment, when they see the people in Jannah, that would increase their regret and their punishment. And they should have been patient in this life by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Zalimeen, the wrongdoers, those who oppose the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the deen of Allah. And they wanted always it to be bent and not to be upon the straight path. And they disbelieved in the last day. So they had characteristics that they led themselves astray till they reached this destination. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the people of Al-A'raf, where the surah is named after them. And these people are either people that their good deeds were exactly equal to the bad deeds. So they did not have enough good deeds for them to enter Jannah, and they did not have enough bad deeds for them to enter the Hellfire. So they will be in place between the Jannah and the Hellfire, and they see the people of Jannah, and they see the people of the Hellfire. Or it was said, as one of the companions radiallahu anhum, he said in the tafsir of the verse, that these are people that they went for the jihad fi sabilillah, fighting for the sake of Allah without the permission of the parents. But the point here is they had good deeds and bad deeds, but equally, And it shows the importance of one good deed and also the danger of one sin. And they will be in between the Jannah and the Hafir for as long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, and then eventually they will enter Jannah as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the verses. And then the people of the Hafir would call upon the people of Jannah for them to pour unto them some water or from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for them. The people of Jannah would say, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade upon the kafirin. Now it's forbidden for them in the Day of Judgment because they used to permit for them what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbidden on the face of earth. Those who took their religion as amusement and play, and they were deceived by this worldly life. So as a result of that, they received the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Day of Judgment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the punishment of the Hafir. The next page, page 157, and verses 52 to 57. And Sheikh Abdul Rahman, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولقد جئناهم بكتاب فصلناه على علم هدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون هل ينظرون إلا تأويله يوم يأتي تأويله يقول الذين نسوه من قبل قد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق فهل لنا من شفعاء فيشفعوا لنا أو نرد فنعمل غير الذي كنا نعمل قد خسروا أنفسهم وضل عنهم ما كانوا يفترون إن ربكم الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش يغشي الليل النهار يطلبه حثيثا والشمس والقمر والنجوم مسخرات يغشي الليل النهار يطلبه حثيثا والشمس والقمر والنجوم مسخرات بأمره ألا له الخلق والأمر تبارك الله رب العالمين ادعوا ربكم تضرعا وخفيا إنه لا يحب المعتدين ولا تفسدوا في الأرض بعد إصلاحها ودعوه خوفا وطمعا إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين وهو الذي يرسل الرياح بشرا بين يدي رحمته حتى إذا أقلت سحابا ثقالا سقناه لبلد ميت فأنزلنا به الماء فأخرجنا به من كل الثمرات كذلك نخرج الموتى لعلكم تذكرون.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most wise, make the matter very clear after we heard what happened to the people in the Day of Judgment, as if we see it with our own eyes and dialogues between the people of the Jannah and the people of the Hawfair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the matter has been made clear to them in this world, and the book is made very clear, guidance and mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers. And if the disbelievers are waiting for the Day of Judgment, it's going to happen. And on that day, the regret would never benefit them, and intercessors would never also benefit them. They ought to be upon the Tawheed and the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the heavens and earth, He's the creator of the heavens and earth. He created them in 6 days, and then He rose over His throne subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way that fits His majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. The day and the night, and how this is creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one after the other, and the sun and the moon and the stars, all under the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creation, He's the creator, and therefore the commands and the obedience is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Rulings, legislation is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since He is the only creator subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whoever do not fulfill the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are transgressing the limits. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling the believers to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to do that in an intense way, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to make it not publicly necessarily, and to be obedient to Allah, because indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love those who transgress the limits in their dua, even in their supplication, by opposing or being not according to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do not spread corruption on the face of earth after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it upright, and invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with fear and hope. Indeed, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near the good doers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the wind, and this is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to bring the provisions to the people and the water that is necessary for their crops and so on. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring the dead alive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the cycle of provisions for the people and the crops and the rain and so on, for a reminder for the human beings that since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that gave life to the dead, where we see that in the crops and cultivation, the same way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would resurrect the people in the Day of Judgment. This will be continued, and some of the stories of the nations before, as it's mentioned earlier, but after the break, so stay with us inshallah.
وذلك هو الفوز العظيم وذلك هو الفوز العظيم
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Welcome back, and with more verses in Surah Al-A'raf. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen and follow the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Page 158 and verses 58 to 67. And Sheikh Ayman, go ahead and recite for us, inshaAllah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. والبلد الطيب يخرج نباته بإذن ربه والذي خبث لا يخرج إلا نكدا كذلك نصرف الآيات لقوم يشكرون لقد أرسلنا نوحا إلى قومه فقال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم قال الملأ من قومه إنا لنراك في ضلال مبين قال يا قوم ليس بي ضلالة ولكني رسول من رب العالمين أبلغكم رسالات ربي وأنصح لكم وأعلم من الله ما لا تعلمون أوعجبتم أن جاءكم ذكر من ربكم على رجل منكم لينذركم ولتتقوا ولعلكم ترحمون فكذبوه فأنجيناه والذين معه في الفلك وأغرقنا الذين كذبوا بآياتنا إنهم كانوا قوما عمين وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره أفلا تتقون قال الملأ الذين كفروا من قومه إنا لنراك في سفاهة وإنا لنظنك من الكاذبين قال يا قوم ليس بي سفاهة ولكني رسول من رب العالمين.
بارك الله فيك، جزاكم الله خيرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the beginning of the page that when it comes to the crops and the plants, as you see, this is an example and a parable that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made very clear. If you plant what is good and the land is fertile and it's there for the plant to grow up good, then it will grow up good. But if the land is not ready for it and it's something that is impure and it's not good for plants, then it's not going to be anything but difficult matters and sparsely and things like this. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the ayat and the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people to be grateful to Allah. The story of Nuh alayhi salam and the story of the people of Ad. Nuh alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him to his people. What did he call his people to be upon? Upon the Tawheed, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the messengers of Allah to the people is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have no one other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to worship. He's the one that is ought to be worshipped subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he warns his people that he fears for them a great punishment in the day of judgment if they disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth that the people, the disbelievers, would oppose this. And they would say that you are in clear astray. And he would reply back to them with matters of goodness. And he would say that I'm a messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I convey the message to you and I have the sincerity and the concern towards you. And I know from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what you don't know. And there's no such a strange thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would send messengers. As it's mentioned earlier, this is the covenant between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the human beings. They disbelieved in Allah, the people of Nuh. As a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Nuh alayhi salam and his people in the ship and caused to drown the rest of the people, the disbelievers. They were people that are blind from seeing the truth. The people of Ad and their prophet Hud is mentioned here also, and the story is repeated throughout the Quran as a reminder for us. What's repeated also is the call of the messengers. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Should you then fear Allah? Al-Mala', the people, those of power, the people of wealth, they opposed it, those who disbelieved among his people. They also said the same thing, similar things, that we think that you are foolish and we think that you are a liar. And he would say to them very politely, very nicely, I'm not foolish. I did not lose my mind. I'm a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you. This will be continued in the next page 159, verses 68 to 73. And Sheikh Ahmed, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أبلغكم رسالات ربي وأنا لكم ناصح أمين. أوعجبتم أن جاءكم ذكر من ربكم على رجل منكم لينذركم واذكروا إذ جعلكم خلفاء من بعد قوم نوح وزادكم في الخلق بسطة فاذكروا آلاء الله لعلكم تفلحون. قالوا أجئتنا لنعبد الله وحده ونذر ما كان يعبد آباؤنا فأتنا بما تعدنا قالوا أجئتنا لنعبد الله وحده ونذر ما كان نعبد آباؤنا قالوا أجئتنا لنعبد الله وحده ونذر ما كان يعبد آباؤنا فأتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين. قال قد وقع عليكم من ربكم رجس وغضب أتجادلونني في أسماء سميتموها أنتم وآباؤكم ما نزل الله بها من سلطان؟ أتجادلونني في أسماء سميتموها أنتم وآباؤكم ما نزل الله بها من سلطان؟ فانتظروا إني معكم من المنتظرين. فأنجيناه والذين معه برحمة منا وقطعنا دابر الذين كذبوا بآياتنا وما كانوا مؤمنين. وإلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره قد جاءتكم بينة من ربكم هذه ناقة الله لكم آية فذروها تأكل في أرض الله ولا تمسوها بسوء فيأخذكم عذاب أليم.
بارك الله فيك، جزاكم الله خيرا. As the story of the people of Prophet Hud, the people of Ad, continues, and he presented to them to the truth, and he has the concern towards them. And this is not a strange thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send a messenger to the people and to remind them of what happened to the nations before, the people of Nuh, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon them the strength and the physical abilities and so on. They denied the truth and they wanted to continue to associate partners with Allah. So as a result of that, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came upon them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Prophet Hud and the people with him, the believers, by the mercy of Allah, and seized the disbelievers, extracted them completely from the face of earth. And then the story of the people of Thamud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Prophet Salih to them, and he commanded his people, invited them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. There's no one worthy of worship except Allah, calling them to La ilaha illallah, which is the same message from one messenger to the other. The matter has been made clear to them, and aiding the prophets with a miraculous thing, which is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did for every messenger of Allah. And with Prophet Salih alayhi salam, it was the she-camel that was assigned to his people, and he warned them to leave it and not to harm it. And this camel by itself to come about as the people, they challenged him and they asked him to bring a camel from Iraq, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted the dua of Salih alayhi salam, and the camel came out from Iraq. And he told them and he warned them not to harm it whatsoever, but of course they did not listen to the commands of their messengers, and they brought the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them, as it's mentioned next in the next page. And also the story of Lut alayhi salam. And Sheikh Asa, please go ahead and recite for us page 160, verses 74 to 81. Go ahead, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Wadhkuru idh ja'alakum khulafa'a min ba'di 'adin wa bawwa'akum fil ardi tattakhidhuna min suhulaha qusuran wa tanhitun تتخذون من سهولها قصورا وتنحتون الجبال بيوتا فاذكروا آلاء الله ولا تعثوا في الأرض مفسدين قال الملأ الذين استكبروا من قومه للذين استضعفوا لمن آمن منهم أتعلمون أن صالحا مرسل من ربه قالوا إنا بما أرسل به مؤمنون قال الذين استكبروا إنا بالذي آمنتم به كافرون فعقروا الناقة وعتوا عن أمر ربهم وقالوا يا صالح ائتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من المرسلين فأخذتهم الرجفة فأصبحوا في دارهم جاثمين فتولى عنهم وقال يا قوم لقد أبلغتكم رسالة ربي ونصحت لكم ولكن لا تحبون الناصحين ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة ما سبقكم بها من أحد من العالمين إنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة من دون النساء بل أنتم قوم مسرفون
بارك الله فيك جزاكم الله خيرا الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned continuing the story of the people of Thamud and how Prophet Saleh reminded them as the previous prophets reminded them of the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the nations before and the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon them they would carve their homes within the mountains and this is such a powerful thing and it's all by the power of Allah So instead of them being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they oppose that with arrogance and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned what the arrogant ones among his people said to those who were weak and oppressed, those who believed among the people of Salih, that they asked him, do you know that Salih alayhi salam is sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his Lord? They said, we believe in that. And the people of arrogance, they said, we disbelieve in what you believe in, out of arrogance that they have. So what they did is that they killed the camel that they asked for it as a miraculous thing and they opposed the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they even said to Prophet Saleh alayhi salam, bring what you have promised us of the punishment of Allah if you are from the messengers of Allah. So they saw the miracle with their own eyes and they still opposed the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they asked for the punishment. So therefore the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to them and they were all seized by the power and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Saleh, he said to them that I had the advice and the concern towards you, but you refuse. You don't love those who give you sincere advices. And this is always the case of the disbelievers and the sinners, those who oppose the commands of Allah. And the mention of Prophet Lut alayhi salam is there when he said to his people, those who committed this evil act of sodomy, he said to his people, you're committing a fahisha, an act of evil and sin, that the nations before never done before. And he said to them that men would have desire towards men instead of women, such an evil sin. And as a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them severely. And this is to be continued in the next page, and also with the people of Madian, page 161, and verses 82 to 87. And Shaykh Abdul Rahman, go ahead and recite for us, inshaAllah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. وما كان جواب قومه إلا أن قالوا أخرجوهم من قريتكم إنهم أناس يتطهرون فأنجيناه وأهله إلا امرأته كانت من الغابرين وأمطرنا عليهم مطرا فانظر كيف كان عاقبة المجرمين وإلى مدين أخاهم شعيبا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره قد جاءتكم بينة من ربكم فأوفوا الكيل والميزان ولا تبخسوا الناس أشياءهم ولا تفسدوا في الأرض ولا تفسدوا في الأرض بعد إصلاحها ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم مؤمنين ولا تقعدوا بكل صراط توعدون وتصدون عن سبيل الله من آمن به وتبغونها عوجا واذكروا إذ كنتم قليلا فكثركم وانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المفسدين وإن كان طائفة منكم آمنوا بالذي أرسلت به وطائفة لم يؤمنوا فاصبروا حتى يحكم الله بيننا وهو خير الحاكمين.
الله فيك جزاكم الله خيرا. The people of Lut, when Lut عليه السلام called them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to abandon this evil sin that they were upon, their response was for the people of Lut, the believers, to stay away, to go out of their town. And they kicked them out of the town. Why? Because they are people that are seeking purity. They want to purify themselves from this filthy sin that they were upon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Lut alayhi salam and his people and his family, except his wife. His wife approved what these evil people were doing, and they were destroyed, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent rain upon them to destroy them, and they were lifted from the earth and they were flipped on the other side and they were smashed and destroyed by the power of Allah. And this is the end of the criminal ones. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in another part of the Quran, وَمَا هِيَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ بِبَعِيدٍ, this punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not too far from the wrongdoers. It's not just for the people of Lut, it's always going to be the case for those who follow the same evil actions. If they're given some time, but the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming. Then the people of Madian are mentioned, and the verses did not get finished yet, and we'll continue that inshallah ta'ala next time. But in the page that we heard the recitation of it, Prophet Shu'aib was sent to the people of Madian, and he called them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and he came to them with clear evidences from Allah. And he commanded them to be just in their buying and selling and in their measures and their scales, and do not take away the rights of the people, do not spread corruption on the face of earth after it's been rectified. And this is what is best for them if they are believers. And don't harm people and don't transgress the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to remember the favors of Allah as been mentioned also to the nations before. And group of people they believed and group of them disbelieved. So he said to them, then be patient till the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes in place, which is the punishment of the disbelievers and the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would save the believers. And then afterwards the verses talks about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Shu'aib and his people, and how he destroyed the disbelievers, the arrogant ones. And the reason and the wisdom behind these stories are mentioned in brief is to remind us the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a continuous one. To be always be among the group of the believers, to be patient with the commands of Allah. Don't be deceived by the ways of the disbelievers when they have the upper hand and superiority. The matter is not going to be forever like this. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come down upon them. And also the concern, as the prophets had the concern towards their people, we should have the concern towards the disbelievers, how to save them from the hellfire. Not to compromise our religion for them, but rather to be good to them by inviting them to the deen of Allah and advising them to save them from the fire of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the disbelievers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who see the reality of things and to be obedient to Allah. I would like to thank the mashayikh, the reciters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for coming, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this recitation in the balance of your good deeds. Until next time, with the continuation of what has been heard, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم مثانية تقشعر منه جلود يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله.